Now we'll see important questions from winding up chapter. State consequences of creation of illegal mortgage. See, the mortgage which is created, say a floating charge which is created 1 year before winding up, this will be treated as illegal mortgage. But in case if there is a genuine mortgage without any malicious intention, then the bankers will get up to 5% of interest, not more than that. Even though say their loan is say 12 or 13%, they will get only 5%. Otherwise, if it is illegal mortgage, then it is null and void. That loan, that security will not be available for even SARFAESI Act. List the contents of interim report. Interim report will have details like what is the share capital of the company, what is the assets available, what is the liabilities, what is the call money dues, contributories, all those details. What are all overriding preferential payments? Overriding preferential payments is only two things. After payment of expenses towards liquidation for the liquidator, his remuneration, the first money goes to secured creditors who is having in par with workman dues. Workman dues and secured creditors are overriding preferential payments. Concept of disclaiming onerous property. Disclaiming onerous property means that asset is no more an asset now. It is even creating a liability. Hence, it is a duty of the liquidator to go to tribunal and disclaim it as onerous property within 1 year. And once the application has been made to tribunal, any other party who is aggrieved has to write a injunction or respond to it within 28 days. Otherwise, the property will be onerous. Liquidator called money from list B contributories. List B contributories told they are no more shareholders in the company. See, to satisfy the definition of contributory, that person should have held the shares at least 6 months in last 18 months. And list A contributory is the person who is having the shares at the time of liquidation. And list B contributories or the shareholders who sold the share to list A contributories in last 12 months. So, list B contributories have to contribute if list A becomes insolvent. Now, next question. Company in the process of winding up. Desired order of priority of payments to creditors. Secured creditors 1 crore, workman dues 25 lakhs, tax dues 5 lakhs, unsecured creditors 10 lakhs, asset realization 80 lakhs. Asset realization of 80 lakhs is not even enough to settle secured creditors and workman dues. So, first these people will be settled in the proportion. Others will not be get any amount. Company got winding up order on January 2017. Mr. A sold his shares on May 2015. He received the notice from the liquidator to pay his call money. See, January 2017 is the order. So 1 year prior to it is January 2016. So Mr. A can be a list B contributory even though he sold the shares, if he sold the shares after 2016. But he sold the shares even well before that, so he cannot be called as list B contributor itself. When will NCLT order for dissolution of the company? Once all the assets has been sold and maximum possible liability has been settled, then NCLT will order for dissolution of the company. What are fraud and preference? If company has taken secured loan in good faith, but creditor has filed winding up petition for fraud and preference. See, fraud and preference is in case if the company has taken any loan with a malicious intention of non-repaying it. At the same time, they know very well that this company will be going for wind up in very next year. So any payment has been made in last 1 year to settle the creditors, they are called fraudulent preference. Okay, any transfer of property or any payments made will be treated as fraudulent preference. There are two things here, 328 and 9. One will talk about 6 months and another will talk about 1 year. That alone you should make sure. One is settlement, another one is transfer of property to related party to non-related party. Both you should keep in mind. If it is in good faith, then no issue. Government company is being wound up and the process is taking more than a year. This question you need not study actually, but sometimes it. Okay, let us go through. The account settlement has been filed only with tribunal and ROC. Please advise. See, if it is a government company, it should be filed with government also. If it is non-government company, ROC and tribunal is okay. That is the answer for this. If not, 5,000 rupees penalty. One of the several business got suspended by the company. Member file winding up petition. Will your answer be different if all the business got suspended? Yeah. See, one of the business out of several business got suspended, no issue. Because company is continuing, they will not go for winding up. If all the business got settled, yes, they have to go for winding up. If holding company suspends its business, but subsidiary company still in operation. Holding company, even though it suspended all its business, if subsidiary company is operating, they cannot file a petition of winding up. Who is in charge for preparation of statement of affairs in the case of winding up? Can the cost be recovered? Contents of statement of affairs, okay, to whom it should be filed? So it will be prepared by liquidator and he will recover the cost from the company. Then state of affairs will contain all those details as I told you in the previous questions. It should be filed with tribunal, then members and creditors. Will have the assets and liabilities of the company basically, with share capital, contributory, everything. Few shareholders became shareholders with the condition entered in the agreement with the promoters, but those conditions never fulfilled by the promoters. Company went into liquidation. Whether the shareholders are liable to contribute? Yes. Once they become the agreement holders, they have to become contributories also, even though the condition is not fulfilled by the promoters. Liquidation expenses they have given, debts to secured creditors, workmen dues, how to share the expenses in proportion of that. Assets realized, workmen dues, secured creditors, unsecured. So you have to first give preference to workmen dues and secured creditors. In their proportion should be settled. Anything left out will be shared by others, but it will not be available here. Declaration of solvency. This actually has been removed from this and taken to IBC, voluntary liquidation. Then company liquidator is a relative of one of the director, hence creditors subjected for in NCLT. Yes, they can do. Okay, if he is a relative of one of the directors, he is interested party, so he has to be removed from the company. NCLT, yes, creditors can approach NCLT for it. Then, foreign company ceases to exist in the home country. Explain status of India. It should get wound up as an unregistered company. But it is not there in your syllabus, so you can remove it. It's just not taken out. Then, so 19th question you can remove from your thing. Then 17 and 19 both can be removed. Can ROC file petition of winding up? If yes, what orders can be passed? Yes, ROC can also file petition of winding up. They can pass interim order and appoint liquidator. Company filed winding up petition. Few shareholders contend that the company has not maintained the books properly. What is the punishment? So punishment, you have to read the concern section for it. Then on September 17, MD of the company transferred certain assets to his company, a son's company. See, this is what I told you, fraudulent preference. There are two things. One is settlement of creditors.